While the p2 of 2 is p2 of 2 is 3 sine square theta, so it is something like this. And now from here we are having some idea, is we have seen the atomic orbitals, and somehow these shapes are like them, but we will discuss them as we go to the atomic orbits. At the moment we discussed the Legendre polynomials and the associated Legendre polynomials, and now when these two will combine, we will have the angular wave functions, and then the radial will also combine with this, and we will have the total wave function of the system or of the state. So these are the associated Legendre polynomials. Similarly, in book on page 169, the mod square of yln theta and phi have been plotted, and it is really hard for me to plot them, but they are on page 169 of the second edition of Griffiths, so one can consult that how they will look like when YLM's mod square are plotted. It is resembling this, but in the book they are plotted in 3D. As I was having the radial wave for the wave function of the first orbit, or I call the ground state, which was psi 100, which I also call a psi 1s, and this was equal to 1 over pi a cube square root e to the power minus r over a, where a we define is the Bohr radius. This is the Bohr radius. So if I plot this wave function, then it is like this, that if I plot r on this axis and psi 1s on this, then it is an exponentially decaying function, setting the value of it 1 over pi a cube is here, then it's a decaying function and it goes like this, and it r equals a, when the radius becomes equals a, then it will be 1 over e times this value. So it will be extending like this, will not be touching here, and it is very very close here to this value. R equal to 0, when r is 0, then we are having e to the power 0, it is 1, and it will be this value. And if I plot the probability of this function, then if on this side I am having r and this is the probability of 1s, then it will be somehow like this, and it is peaked at, means the maximum probability is occurring when r is equal to a, the Bohr radius. So this is the 1s orbit, and the s orbit is actually going till the nucleus, because this is r equal to 0, this is the nucleus, and this is extending as well like this. So I cannot say that the idea of the Bohr was right, because he considered that this is nucleus and the electron is going around it at a specific distance. So it's not like this. Because this idea violates the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, we know exactly the momentum and the position of the particle at the same time. Rather, it is like the distribution means this is like electron cloud which is around this nucleus. So an electronic cloud is around this nucleus such that the maximum probability is at this point. So we are having the maximum probability here actually. When we draw an orbit, then at this orbit we are having the maximum probability, and we call this is the electron cloud. So its probability goes till the nucleus, and from the nucleus the probability starts, it becomes maximum like this. Let me plot here that how this one looks like. So it will look like this. The probability starts here, becomes maximum here, and then goes down like this. So we have this is the means the electron is probable in this range, and the maximum probability is at the Bohr radius. So the electron is not confined to a particular orbital distance, and when we want to find the electron, we will have to find its probability. So it is not a specific orbit, and that's the reason that the quantum mechanical solution is different from the Bohr model. So we say that the hydrogen wave function in the ground state is symmetric, is spherically symmetric. So in hydrogen atom, the wave function is spherically symmetric in the s orbit, and the densest part where the probability is maximum, the densest portion of electron is called the orbit of that electron. Now we know that the energy of an electron depends strictly on n, which is the principal quantum number, which give us the orbit or shell. We call it shell, we call it orbit. And then this is actually equal to n. And then we call the subshell, or we call it the orbitals as well, means this is also called orbitals, subshells, orbitals, and they are due to the number L, which we call the orbital quantum number. And number of electrons, here I can write the number of electrons in a shell or in a subshell. And so here we have, when n is equal to 1, when n is equal to 1, we call this the K shell, and we will have the L value equal to 0 only. the only possibility, because we know that L should be less than this, is this possibility, and we call such an orbit is the S orbit. While S is from sharp, this is from sharp lines, and the number of electrons here are actually two. Number of electrons, let me say that they are in a orbit, and here the number of electrons in orbital. So the number of electrons in orbitals will also be 2. When n is equal to 2, that is the principal quantum number is 2, we will call this is L shell, and here the possibility for L is that it can have values 0 and 1, and we will call the 0 as usual is S orbit, and the 1 we will call is P orbit, P from principal. So now the number of electrons here in S are 2, while in P the number of electrons are 6. So the total numbers here is 8. Similarly, when N is equal to 3, we will call this is the M shell. And now here, the L is having the chance to have values 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, not 3, because it will be equal to n then. And here we will have S, P, and D, while D is from diffuse. Here, the 2, 6, the S will have 2 electrons, the P will have 6 electrons, and the D will have 10 electrons. So the total number of electrons will be 18 here, which is the 2n square formula here, that the electrons are changing, the total number of electrons are like 2n squared. So n1 we have 2, n2 we have 8, and 3 we have 18. Similarly, when n is equal to 4, we will have the n shell. The shell we will call is n, or the energy is dependent on n only, and we will have the values of L is 0, 1, 2, and 3, and the orbitals is this 0 is called S, then 1 is called P, N is equal to 1, N is equal to 2 is called F from, D from diffuse, and when L is equal to 3, we call it F from fine, and so we have the electrons is 2, 6, 10. And in F, we will have 14. So the total number of electrons in this shell will be 4 squared, 16 into 2 will come out to be 32. So the number of electrons like this. Similarly, the shells will go on, while the SPDF will go on alphabetically as well, and we will have G, H, I, and so on. So the SPD or the shells, they are same in all the elements, like the one that we have done for the hydrogen, they are the same for the other elements as well. However, they are exactly the same for the one electron system, like helium plus or lithium 2 plus, as I have said earlier. But when the other elements, many electron comes in, then we will have to solve the Schrodinger equation for the many electron system, and their values, well, the orbits will be the same, but their energies and distribution will be affected, it will be modified. So this way we explained that the quantum model is not of a specific orbit, but the specific orbit is having maximum probability here. So this was the 1s. I am restricting myself to the 1s, is it is easy to explain. I will explain a little bit the p orbit as well, while the other, the d and f, it is very hard to plot, so one may consult some computer graphics to plot these.